Yes, folks. So shall we start with the class or should we wait for others?
We can start.
Maybe. Exactly, even I agree with this. You guys give your consents? Who's 1 plus 7? 1 plus 7 is 8. I know this much of mathematics. Who's the student of mine? Very mysterious, by the way. Anyways, I'm sharing the slides. I'm starting on with the class, guys. Here. Today, we shall be doing analysis of words and phrases. Right?
Okay.
Guys, you'll have to give your nods so that I may know who's listening and who's not. All right?
Yes, ma'am.
I'd appreciate
yes, ma'am.
Give your feedbacks, please. All right. Now, if I say that, you know, you just have to analyze. I'm sitting comfortably and I'm teaching you guys. And now I say, soon I will be crossing English Channel. I just say this. Do you think I can do that?
No.
No, ma'am.
Exactly. Not at least in this weather. Not at least towards the end of, you know, November or probably. I can't do it. I don't even know how to swim. All right. So this is how you analyze. Fine. Now, another thing. I say the duo factor of GST and demonetization, which has affected the Indian economy over the span of 6 months. Within 6 months, both of these, you know, were implemented. My economy is going to take another 2 years to recover from these two setbacks. What do you analyze?
That this GST and demonetization was bad for the economy and it was a wrong decision and it will take some time for
the economy to recover. This is what you analyze, yeah. Right?
Yeah.
No, this is exactly what I'm trying to say, that at times you have to look into the bigger picture. You don't have to focus on GST and demonetization. You just have to focus that two setbacks were given by the government of India to the masses of India, and the economy is going to take another 2 years to recover from these two, you know,
okay.
Shocks. Got it?
Okay. Yes,
you get this? Now, there is Akshat also, there is Ved also, there is Sukman also, there is Abdul Ghani also, there is Meenal also, and there is Sidhesh also, there is Chetna also. And how many are participating? Just you and I. Guys, wake up. Are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
So
yes,
why every time I say, are you there, then only you say, yes, ma'am. You can also budge into the conversation, right? Is there anybody who would like to quote an example for analysis of words and phrases? I'll take you to the text also, but let's keep it practical. Let's keep it more real. How many of you are acquainted with the English, with the Hindi language?
Not really, I don't.
Okay. Me.
You are, okay. Now there's something which I'm typing, let me know. I'm typing in English only.
Oh.
How many of you can read this?
I can read this, ma'am.
You can understand it as well?
Yeah.
Okay, it's about punctuation, right?
Yeah.
First sentence is saying, Roku mat, jane do. I mean, do not stop the person who's going. Let the person leave.
Yeah.
All right? And then the second, Roku mat jane do. Another sentence is saying, stop the person who's leaving. First sentence, do not stop the person. Second sentence, stop the person. It's the magic of the, you know, single comma. You get this?
Yes.
So this is how you understand. Fine. Now.
Okay.
Any in a minute's time, you shall be able to have the right answer. Right? So, what are the key highlights here? What is the subject and the predicate here?
Like, the subject will be the right answer.
Yes.
And the predicate will be in a minute's time.
Exactly. So, if we focus, minute's time and right answer. Right? Minute's time, right answer. This is what you have to focus on. All right, this is how you focus on the keywords. Right? Another thing,
okay,
when you start to answer the question, like just the way I discussed about GST and demonetization with all of you, basically, not with just one student, guys. So what did we see? That economy is impacted. The economy is disturbed. People are worried. There is joblessness. There is unemployment. There is poverty. And we are making, you know, Gandhi solar power panel park in New York City in USA. And we have time to make another, you know, port in Iran, which is Chabahar port. And we are giving enough money to Russia also on the line of credit. So basically, India is a poor country with rich people. We have got Audis on the road. We have got people riding BMWs. We have got people riding Mercedes. And they are not, you know, cheap cars. They're expensive cars. And still, India is a poor country with rich people. You guys agree or don't?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Just because I am saying this, so it is yes, ma'am. Now, I am going to keep quiet for the next 1 minute and you are going to come up with few examples. Come on. Enough of me talking. Go ahead. Who's quoting an example?
Should the example be about punctuation marks or something else?
Quote any example in which you just have to focus on the gist of the passage, not what is written in the passage.
Okay. Ma'am, there's a let's eat grandpa where you put the comma after let's eat.
Oh, this is an interesting one. Wait. Let me write it down. Very nice. By the way, who's talking? May I know your name?
Abdul.
Okay, Abdul. Wait. Let's eat grandpa. Okay, this is an interesting example. You want to eat your grandpa?
No, ma'am.
Abdul, you don't have to take me literally, yaar. Come on. Let's eat grandpa. Yes, what do you want me to do now?
Ma'am, you can add a comma after eat.
Yes.
And if you don't add a comma, then it looks like you're trying to eat your grandpa.
Yes. A good one, man. Good one. Excellent. Anybody else? Abdul, very good example, boss. I'm really proud of you. Anybody else? Arey Baba, I can see Aditya on the top of the list. Aditya, hi Aditya. Would you like to participate, beta, please? Aniket is back. Welcome back, Aniket.
Yeah,
and I know you're going to text me in private, ma'am. I'm already done with this, but still you are going to be a part of this.
Yeah, ma'am.
I'm not letting you go.
Okay, ma'am. No problem.
Cool. Sudesh?
I have an example one, ma'am.
Go ahead. I would love to have the example.
Yes, so this is actually a true incident. There was a man, he was supposed to be hanged, he was supposed to be hung, but what happened was that he got a presidential pardon. So the president said, leave him, don't kill. So what happened was the typist who was typing it, he was in such a hurry, he put the comma after don't. So in the original one, we leave him, comma, don't kill him. And in the other one, it is leave him, don't kill.
Oh.
So it ended up costing that man his life.
Who was this man?
I'm not sure about the name, but this is true story. It happened in America.
Okay. Leave him, don't kill.
So he was lucky leave enough him, to get a pardon, but fate was not on his side.
Oh, that's nice. Wonderful. Anybody else? Arey Baba, this is such a fun class and I've got such beautiful students to teach. No, I can't see your faces, but I can make out you all are very good when it comes to intelligence. So that's what I'm interested in. So how about, I think, Aditya, would you like to participate, beta? Aniket just did. Sudesh, are you going to be a silent partner? Shaurya, Akshat, Chetna, Meenal, Abdul just did. Sukman, Suri, Ved. Guys, who's this 1 plus 7? I'm still, you know, wondering. 1 plus 7 is 8. No, I have no answer from him. You can send me a private message also. Though I'm going to read it aloud later, but that's okay. Now, are we done with the analysis of words and phrases, guys? I'm in a class. Now, we are done with this. Analyzing words and phrases. Now, just read the passage, focus on the words in bold, and tell me what are the meanings that you derive, the variety of meanings. And I'm going to be silent now. The Romans were able to gain the upper hand.
Ma'am, according to the paragraph, forces is like the army of Hannibal from Carthage.
All right. Now, if I ask you not to focus on the passage, what is your answer going to be? Wait up. How many words are there? Forces, gain, giant, power. Forces, gain, giant, power. Forces, gain, giant, power. Now you have to do the like this. Force, strength, army, soldiers. Now for gain, what all meanings do you interpret?
Profit.
Yes. Are you a commerce student, beta?
No, I'm not. I'm a ninth.
Okay. Profit, all right.
Acquire.
What?
Acquire.
Acquire, nice. Yes, acquire is a good word to use. Oh, I should have written it here. Giant.
Huge.
All tall. Right. Huge.
Tall.
Yeah. How many of you have read Chacha Chaudhary?
Yeah, me.
You yes,
ma'am. Yeah.
No. You know, it reminds me of the planet Jupiter. I am just imagining something. You know, if we replace moon with one of the planets, and let's say if Jupiter takes the place of moon, how the site is going to be? Interesting thought, right?
Yeah.
Now, giant. Another word for giant, guys?
Important.
What?
Ma'am, the mythical race, or like that mythical creature.
Massive.
Massive. This is
important or main.
This is for which word, Beta?
A giant. Like Microsoft is a tech giant.
Okay. So you want to write important, right?
Yes.
Now, do you want to add another word to gain?
Earn.
Yes. I could not even think of it. Nice. And for forces?
Push or pull.
Okay. Somebody has
ma'am, can we add learn to gain?
Yes, we can. I can't say no to this. Yes. Learn and earn. It's an earn we have already done with. Learn, yes. Now for power, guys, why are we, you know, why there is apartheid being applied to power? Come on. Synonyms.
Control.
Control.
Important. Control. Oh, that could also fit there.
Which word it is?
Ma'am, important.
Important, guys, I need help here. Important will fit in the category of power?
I don't think so.
Good.
Not yeah, exactly.
It's good. It could still.
You're saying something, Beti. Express yourself freely. Just do not stop yourself.
Because like you say someone is in power. Like,
who's talking, by the way? May I know?
Siddhesh.
Okay, yes, Siddhesh, Beti.
Like, we say that BJP is in power right now.
So it is important.
Important.
Okay, like giant has come in two places. Important has come under two categories, giant and power. All right. Others?
Again, related to
strength.
Beta, I couldn't get you. Once again, please.
Ma'am, I was thinking energy.
Yes. Yes.
Competence.
Ma'am, even strength could fit in here, like from forces.
I agree. I agree with this word. Strength. Yes, I agree with this word, and I agree with energy as well. Now, for giant, guys, one word. For giant.
Humongous.
Yes. You know, the only time I've heard the usage of this particular word has been in reference to the, you know, fame Madhuri Dixit earned or Steven Spielberg could manage to earn. They were humongous names, right? Are you acquainted with these two names or you aren't?
Yes,
ma'am.
When your parents also were, I'm sure they were not even married. Since then, I've been hearing these names. When I was very small, since then, I've been hearing these names. And these two names are still brands. So I agree with the word humongous for giant. Good. I'm really liking it, yeah? You guys are participative. Cool. Now, one word for forces. We are done with strength. We are done with army, soldiers. Push or pull.
Violent.
Hmm?
Violent.
Violent. As in violence.
Lawful.
Huh?
Lawful.
Lawful will come under this, guys, everybody?
Unlawful would come under that.
Unlawful will come under forces.
No,
lawful forces.
I think if I'm going by the word, it's law which is going to fit in here. We are talking about. Chalo, what we have done is we have tried to interpret different meanings for the single word, right? It was not necessarily supposed to be with reference to the passage. Done, guys?
Yes.
Now,
yes, ma'am.
Understood the punctuation marks factors.
Yes, ma'am.
You know, Aniket quoted an example, I quoted an example, and Abdul Ghani quoted an example. So is there anybody else who would like to quote an example? I will welcome it. Please, guys, feel free. Is there anybody who would like to give an example? Hello?
Yes.
Anybody else with any other example? No. So I'm putting you on the exercise. I'm slightly disappointed, guys. I mean, it was fun when it came to writing down meanings, different meanings to the word, but anyways, here we go. Aniket is going to explain the logic, and you guys are going to give me the right answer. It's about analysis of words and phrases. Go ahead, guys. Start to read the passage and see how much time you take to attempt the questions.
I can't see the whole question.
Oh, yes, I'm sure you can. Here.
I'm done.
Just a second. I know everybody can see the screen. A. Aniket Varnika Shorya. Wow. Sudhir says A. You guys can see the screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, ma'am.
The ones who are responding to the answers? You guys can see that?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
yeah,
ma'am.
Oh, okay. That's cool. Now, finally some new people are participating. It's such a pleasure, guys. When you guys start to, you know, behave like a team, you become one family, it is really very, you know, tranquilizing. The class becomes fun. I am enjoying teaching. Just be participative, guys. I don't like dull classes. What's the point behind teaching a group then? And such ignited brains, such young brains, fresh minds. So I'm moving on to the next question. Yes, answer A is correct. Is there anybody who needs to be explained the logic behind it?
No, ma'am. It's
pakka pakka?
Yes, ma'am.
Once
yes, ma'am.
This passage, I'll be giving you a passage of my own. Here we go to this. Guys, how much time did you take to attempt this one?
20 seconds.
Cool. And others? Wonderful. Huh?
30 seconds.
I couldn't get you, Rita. 30 seconds?
The answer is D.
Okay, wow. No, while I'm discussing how much time you guys took. So I have my, you know, son answering the question when the answer is D. Anybody else? Anybody else?
I'm D.
Yes, D is the right answer. I am having...
Yes, ma'am, it's D.
All right. D. Varnika, D. Chetna, Minal, D. Anybody else? So I'm just moving ahead. Guys, you just read the passage and I'll be right back. All right, I'm just coming back. Hello?
Ma'am, can you scroll down?
Yes, please.
Ma'am B.
All right.
Ma'am B.
Yes, now when you call me now, Sukman. 1+7. I'm still curious who's 1+7. Sidhesh. All right. Fine. Done, done. Yes, guys, the answer is correct. Is there anybody who needs to be explained why this particular answer is correct?
No, ma'am.
Anybody? No, ma'am.
Guys, I want answer from all of you. Is there anybody
no,
who needs to no, be explained?
No, ma'am.
So I'm just taking it as a green signal. Why did 1+7 leave? Who was that?
Ma'am, actually, I'm using my mom's phone today, so I didn't know the name was not my name, so that's
okay, who is this?
Ma'am, Rishi.
Rishi, that's perfectly all right. You may use it. Okay, you just changed the
name. No, yeah, I just changed the name.
Okay, no, I respect it. I mean, with females, it's better not to reveal the correct names. So that's okay, Rishi. I regard that. I respect that, rather. Now, question, and I'm sorry if I've hurt you. I'm really
no,
sorry.
Ma'am.
That was not it's the intention. Fine. I was just trying to be light. Now, question number 4.
B.
Arey Baba, sawal ko padha karo. I mean, before even I started, who was that?
B. Ma'am, Aniket.
Aniket, not fair.
Okay.
Even I have not even started to read the question, and my son is ready with the answer also.
Ma'am, I read the question while we were still discussing the third question.
Guys, this is what you learned from Aniket. While the world is busy talking, it's better you focus on your deeds, right? Talking tiger never bites, laughing tiger never bites. Have you heard of the poem? I just remember these two lines, guys. I heard it when I was in class 8, way back in, I don't even remember the year. Okay, anybody else would like to give the answer? Fourth B. That's good, Chetna. I don't know, by the way. I need to check my notes also. Now, if Aniket is saying the answer has to be this only, but... Alright. B, 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 B. Uh-oh. Varnita, Sukman, Nimal, Mohammad. That's nice, guys. Right. Everybody else? Rishi? Ved?
Ambi.
Ved? Beta, what is the right answer? B. Wait, your mic is not working even today? Or you can be a part of the conversation. Wait. Beta, can you talk? No, it isn't. Okay. Fine. You're still with us. We are with you and you're with us. Cool. Now we move on to the question number 5. Guys, do we remember that 10 minutes hitch?
Yes.
The class is not over. Come back.
Ma'am, C and D, the third and fourth option.
Okay. What is the meaning of tepid? Are you pronouncing it or tepid?
Ma'am, in this case, like moderate or going neither side, not being excited.
All right. Others? Doesn't it mean lacking in passion or probably in force?
I think C. Third one.
Okay. All right. Achha, listen, guys. This is an open-ended answer. For this, no answer is the perfect answer. All right, guys. The answer can be anything. Fine?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. I'll do one thing. Yeah.
Ma'am, D.
Ma'am, B.
Who said B?
Aniket.
Sneenal Varnika Aditya. All right. Fine. Meenal. Meenal and Varnika.
Yes, ma'am.
It's my humble request to the two of you. Kindly explain why do you think option D is correct?
Ma'am, this is Varnika.
All right.
Hello?
Yes, yes, Bitte. Go ahead.
Oh, okay. So basically, it's written that a single light shone. Basically, light makes an object shine. It doesn't make anyone gasp for air, or it's not an exotic plant or a natural paint. It just shows a shiny surface. So
yes, that's ma'am. Right.
Okay. Aniket, why do you think option B is correct?
Ma'am, so basically correct only, it's a light, but it's given that it creates a burning orange patina. So the closest thing that patina can mean in this case is a paint.
Or I agree with Aniket.
Yeah,
But
so
the thing is,
it can't be shiny. It can't be a surface. It has to be a paint.
It can't be a paint because the...
Read the question. Read the line. Put a shiny surface instead of patina. No, just do that. Replace patina with a shiny surface. Then try to read it in your mind. How does it sound? Does it sound correct? If it sounds correct, then I'm wrong. But if it sounds wrong, then I'm right. Got it? Just try putting it. Replace it. See that it doesn't make sense at all. And directly eliminate it. It's very close to the correct option, but it's not going to be it. The sentence is incomplete.
I love the confidence. Shreya, what do you have to say?
Ma'am?
Yes. Shreya.
I've heard the word before. It literally means a coating of oxide. So it's not exactly shiny. So I would again go for a natural paint because it naturally occurs.
Thank you.
No. It could be.
Indeed.
Wait a minute. Shorya are like best friends for this class. Now anybody else who would like to express? I'm loving it, guys. Now finally my class is alive. Sukma, do you have to say anything?
Which answer is right?
I'm not expressing. I mean, my students are still, you know, discussing that. I'm really liking it.
Deeper ball.
Ma'am, why won't it be D?
I did not say anything. I have not even said that Aniket.
I can maybe answer your question. It says burning orange patina, a shiny surface. You're using a similar term for describing it. Burning orange and shiny. Burning orange is shiny. If you get what I say.
Yeah, that is true.
Yeah, that's what they asked.
But if you read it,
orange patina. Yeah, so listen.
Correct only. Replace the word. No, see, when you're using a
okay, I'm replacing the word. Listen,
the shiny surface also in its place. Suppose you're walking and there's light, so the color is orange, but then it's shining, right? So, I mean, the shine is the orange color, so
okay.
And also reading it out, it says that led to the house's front door a burning orange shiny surface. How does that sound wrong?
Okay, yeah, I'll read the sentence out to you using a shiny surface. Just listen to it. A single light shone from the second floor window and cut through the night, giving the walkway that led to the house's front door a burning orange shiny surface. In what angle? Wrong? Does that sound correct?
Yeah, so that's why they've used the word patina. But patina doesn't necessarily, I mean, it could have so many different meanings, right?
Okay, so listen. Correct. I mean, patina might have so many different meanings.
And outlining the steps that shone like well-polished shoes. Now, well-polished shoes are shiny. They're not naturally painted. So read the next part of the sentence.
This is basic English grammatical rules. You do not use two same adjectives to express something. You do not say tremendous and large. You do not say tremendous and large.
Natural pain. Explain.
Would you like to explain this, guys? Rishi also have got.
Yes, it already does because burning orange already says that it's shining. I shine a burning orange.
Adding Aniket's, it says well polished shoes. Well polished shoes are obviously shining.
Yeah,
it's already expressed in the sentence. Why do you want to add more?
It's already expressed. So
we don't need to want to add again. You don't need to extend it.
But it's not wrong if you say well shiny.
It's not wrong, but it's not proper. It's not colloquial.
Burning orange can mean a bright orange. All right? Burning orange doesn't mean shiny orange. Burning orange can be a bright orange, which is caused, I mean, like, it's shown by a shiny surface. And that so I mean, like, it looks like well-polished shoes. Come on. I mean, burning orange is the color and shiny surface is a different thing. So burning does not necessarily mean shiny. It can mean it can mean a really bright orange.
Okay, fine. Suppose you are right. Suppose you
Aniket,
are
Aniket,
right.
Give me a second. Aniket, give me a second. See, I would like to introduce this, give an example of a sentence. Your teeth are burning my eyes. What does that make sense? What makes sense to you in that? It means that the teeth are so shiny. You don't need to say your teeth are so shiny, they're burning my eyes. That's just repetition.
Exactly. That is repetition. You're saying the same thing again.
But that
it's already implied.
Burning.
Why
burning
would you say something that's already implied? It's grammatical.
Exactly.
Burning doesn't necessarily have to mean shiny. Burning can
in this case, it does. See, you are. That's right like say no.
After
see,
I restart the class. I'll tell the right answer. Trust me, I'm loving the conversation. It's such a beautiful feeling. But guys, I'm coming back. Don't go anywhere. The class is going on. The class is not over yet.